stuff happens.
Angry? Who's angry?
And with so many ways to damage your car, there's one right way to fix it.
Minor Wreck Express saves you time and money.
Minor Wreck Express on Northwest Beaver Drive in Johnston.
Well, hi, I'm Rob Spearman. I'm a broker owner of RE/MAX Real Estate Concepts in Des Moines, Iowa. Give us a call if you're looking at buying or selling a home, or if you're having trouble on your mortgage payments or looking to purchase foreclosures. We have the agents to help you, experienced, outstanding agents. Our office number is 515-276-2872. Or if you'd like to look at homes, go to our website, homeconnectusa.com.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are.
Let me ask you something. Is the fivefold ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you.
What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine.
Well, hi, welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Lage. We have a special guest tonight, Sherry Locke. Lucky or Locke?
Locke.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Yeah, and I just have to tell you some news really quick. We're certified with the John G. Lake Ministries and for the Divine Healing Technicians. And we asked if we could have a healing room with their name on it, and they said yes. And so they gave us that, and they'll have us up on their website soon.
Congratulations.
And so we are really excited. And there's more news to come later, but we can't say now.
Praise
so
God.
It's so cool what God's doing and how he's moving. So we know that God's done a lot in your life, and you have a lot of different things to tell us about miracles.
Yes, God's done a lot of things in my life. I don't know where you would like me to start, though.
Well, just what was the latest vision that you got from God?
The latest vision?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know what? I actually get several in the course of a night.
Oh, really?
Yes, I do.
Oh, wow.
And I write them all down.
Uh-huh.
And God actually showed me a vision about a certain person in our church the night before church started, and it did play out. I'm not going to exactly share that, but it was very helpful, and we were able to work as a church together, and mm-hmm. Visions are very short for me, uh-huh. visions or dreams, either one, but it's all a communication from God, and I praise God for that gift. That's my latest one. I can't say. Do you know, I actually have a stack of books that I keep.
Wow.
my logs.
You write them all.
I write them all down.
So how long have you been having those? Do you remember?
That I knew they were the actual visions. Uh-huh. I've probably had a couple years.
Uh-huh.
A couple years.
And so you have a stack of notebooks.
Yes.
With them. Wow.
They've gotten more. They've increased the how much I get.
Yeah.
But I've learned how to. I don't know, receive it, I guess.
Yeah.
I'm more comfortable with it, and mm-hmm. I just receive more and more all the time.
Right. I think the more that we do get used to whatever it is that God's doing with us, whether, you know, he gives us words of knowledge to tell somebody or prophecy, that the more we do it, the more comfortable we are with it.
Go ahead. Oh. One that he gave me just in the last couple days was a ping pong paddle. Mm-hmm. And I looked at that, and then the world appeared about on the back of it, the part that I could see,
uh-huh.
and a ball dropped from above,
uh-huh.
and it served.
Okay. I can see it.
Would you like me to discern that?
Yeah. I'm getting a blank right now.
he's trying to get me to step out there and do my part. He's given me several things uh-huh. that direction, but
I know
my take
what you mean.
On that. Yep.
Sometimes he tells us things to do, and I know personally for myself that if we don't do what he's told us to do at one point, and then he's not going to give us the next step until we do the first one.
Right.
So there is more, but. Thank you, God. He just kind of gave me that revelation, you know. Yeah. I mean, I've thought of it before, but he just had to remind me again. And I've noticed that recently, that I've been trying to really do what he told me to do a while back. And I can see that things are changing because I am being obedient. So
that's important.
Yeah,
That's important because lots of times he'll give you stuff that's not quite in your comfort zone.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
You're like Dave in the radio show.
Yeah, well, it's not in your comfort zone, but you know what? If he tells you that, you know what? One of the more recent things he gave me, and I don't know if this had happened last time I talked to you, but I have I got set free from eating certain things.
Oh yeah. 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 That's cool.
That was big, and that was immediate, and that
yeah.
was he actually I got Rema words with that, and
uh-huh.
and that told me my liver couldn't take that anymore.
Right.
And then I just got set free from that kind of eating, and I know I'm a big girl, but I've dropped a lot of weight since
uh-huh.
since that point, and that's all God, praise God.
Right, yeah.
That's all God.
Yeah, okay, God, you can give me a word now. I need to lose weight too. So, but what else has he given you? Maybe like the biggest one.
The biggest one?
The one that means the most to you.
Well, there's a lot of them that mean a lot to me, and
just
the whole seer anointing, when he told me and gave me the seer anointing, and that is what he told me,
mm-hmm.
that was big for me.
Sure.
As he started me in this, it was like in baby steps,
uh-huh.
and each step along the way, it's like he gives you a series of promotions,
right?
And the way he tells you that, and it's so sweet, and it was so caring, and then you realize God's there just for you,
mm-hmm.
and of course he's there just for everyone,
right?
But at the same, the miracle is that at the same time he's there for everyone, he's there just for you.
Yeah, yeah.
And some of the biggest ones, one of the biggest ones was when I had Rhema words where he actually spoke some. He reprimanded me on a couple things,
mm-hmm.
and he spoke those words out loud. I don't get that so much,
right?
But I have gotten that, and those are really big to me. I've had angel visitations, and those mm-hmm. are big to me. I had two angels this week. at the same time. And I got to say, I didn't handle that all that well.
Did it scare you?
It scared me. And honestly, I came out of a deep sleep and they were right there and I sat up and rebuked them. And then I realized they were angels.
Well, when you just wake up, you're just not very with it. I'm sure God wasn't mad at you. He's probably laughing.
Well, I had to say, I'm so sorry. I realized they're there. They're all white and glowing and I didn't handle that well, but that isn't how I've always handled that.
Well, God gives us grace, and I'm sure he probably was just laughing. He didn't mean to have him scare you, I'm sure, but...
And that is biblical, because that's what he did to Mary and Joseph and others.
You know, there is a fear. You can have a... You can the presence
not.
Can be so great when you have an angelic visitation that... One time it was so great and so there that I had to turn over on my stomach and I quaked. It was that strong. I cannot say that was an angel. There wasn't a vision with that. Yeah. The presence was there, though.
Yeah.
The presence was there, and I've never had it that strong where it, of fear. But it was of
the
God.
Fear of the Lord, yeah.
It was of God. Another one that was really, really special to me was I had asked some very specific things, and he gave me just very specific answers.
Oh, cool.
But there was it was an ongoing dialogue, and that was a beautiful night because I've had prayers and then had them be answered, and you had to actually sometimes I get so carried away with prayers that I'm not sure what answer certain things are, which questions they relate to.
Okay,
you know?
Yeah.
But on this particular night, I got to dialogue back and forth, and that was just beautiful.
That was
absolutely beautiful.
Well, sure.
Because I know that I was awake, and I cannot say, I remember I was awake, and it was open-eyed, and there was a visual with it the whole time, but I do not recall there being any spoken words to me, but I know that I was speaking back to it. There was always a total understanding of what was being said to me,
right.
And then I responded to it, and then the visions would change right with the responses, and it was just like an ongoing a dialogue that just went on quite a long time, and I was able... that's happened to me two different times. And one time it was about our church and the visions he had for our church.
Uh-huh.
And I was able to come to church and say, I'm a co-pastor of a church in Iowa. And I was able to say what those things were. And we were able to agree together as a church.
Mm-hmm. Well, tell them where you are. We want to lift your church up.
Right.
Well, one of those things was that we were going to have an expansion and a remodeling and things that he wanted done and how he wanted it done, which seemed fairly amazing since we had like passed the hat for weeks and weeks for a building project and we had all of $100 and some mm-hmm. in it and yet we claimed it and we had a really nasty kitchen area and dining area and God wanted it a certain way and he spoke about that and so we claimed it, and somehow within like 3 weeks or so, we had it all.
Wow.
We had it all.
No, I meant to say your address and the name of your church so people know how to visit you.
Yeah.
Well, the address of our church is 113 North Main, Hedrick, Iowa, and we have two services on Sundays. We have an 11 o'clock service with Pastor Gary Smith. Does a sermon on Sunday mornings, and then I do the Sunday evening service at 6 o'clock on Sundays.
And Gary was on 2 weeks ago, so
yes.
People can look back and see the video of him when he was here. So and tell us a little bit about your church, too. You have all kinds of walks of life that come in there. And
all
you
kinds
guys...
of walks of life. We do a post-jail ministry. Gary and I... have been involved in jail ministry on different levels at different times, and we have a post-jail ministry for people who are out of jail or out of prison. Perhaps they're in homeless shelters, and we provide rides for them.
Mm-hmm.
We provide food for them. We have a real intimate group of people. It's not a large congregation, and yet God gives our lessons to one individual in the church, and someone else teaches that lesson, and seems like he also individually ends up giving Gary and I each the same topic, although we don't confer about it.
Yeah. Well, that's cool. God has a way of doing that, doesn't he?
He sure does.
It's pretty neat how he can, he can just orchestrate so many different things. We just can't even wrap our mind around the way that he does things, you know?
We don't even have words in the English language that contribute to how big and how glorious his works are.
Right, yeah. Yeah, we had a friend of ours, Melissa, on last week, and she went to Honduras, and God just, he ordained it. He had people just step up to the plate and buy her airplane ticket, and a few days later, she was gone and had the money to pay for lawyers and for her travel down there and everything. Just, it was so quick. She came to our house on a Saturday night, and she left to go to Honduras on Thursday. He's just amazing how he can make things work, you know?
Yes. I just did think of a big one.
Yeah, okay.
A big one was my very first, wasn't my first communication with God. He'd given me several things to the point that I realized, ooh, he's talking to me on a regular basis. And then I started researching this and, you know, trying to get mentored on this.
Right.
Getting direction and realize the whole point is that you're supposed to speak it and pass it on. And if you don't pass it on, you know, you're telling God that's not worthy of being said.
Right.
And so I was doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's not necessarily readily accepted out there.
Yes.
Mainstream.
I know.
So, you know, there were the occasional eyebrows, mostly by my own family.
Yeah.
You know, and I was praying out loud to God and saying, why have you given me this gift? Why? Because this is a hard one. This is, you're having to stand there and speak for your own credibility. And he gave me a number, and I wrote it down. And I looked and I pondered that number for a very long, I said, I don't know. I said, I don't know one person personally that has this gift. If you could just tell me one person I know. And he gave me this number, and I visions are short and they're quick, but I did write this number down.
Yeah.
And I looked at this number for a long time and tried to figure it out, and I realized it may be a phone number, and I dialed it. Well, I dialed it.
Yeah.
And I came into it was a conference call of prophets, okay? Now that's pretty random in itself, right? Okay, so I'm thinking this is really cool. So you're confirming that there are prophets out there alive today that are speaking, and they were giving the word to people, and I spoke and they couldn't hear me. And then at the end they were signing off.
Yeah.
And they were saying, prophets, that's it for tonight. We're going to reconvene about 6 o'clock. If you get back on the line at certain times, and all this time I'm saying hello, and they can't hear me, and I'm thinking, this is just the coolest thing. I've just sat here for an hour and listened to prophecy. It was beautiful. They had a head moderator, and then for some reason I said hello one more time, and this girl goes, hello. And I said, oh, you can hear me? She goes, yes. She goes, are you, wait a minute, where's this call coming from? She said, are you from Iowa? And I said, yeah. Yeah. She goes, Sherry, is that you? I said, yes. And she goes, this is Gloria. The head prophetess was my roommate from college.
Oh, cool. So God gave you a big one, didn't he?
Yeah, he gave me a big one.
Oh, my gosh. He's so cool.
Yeah, and I was to preach that night, and I had my sermon all written, to which I ripped that thing up. And
you had to talk all about this.
Yeah, I did. I had to.
Oh, I'm sure. That's cool. Well, we're going to take a short break. We're going to be right back, and we'll hear more of what God has been talking to you about.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
from the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios. This is Webcast One Live.
No matter how well you drive, stuff happens.
Angry? Who's angry?
And with so many ways to damage your car, there's one right way to fix it.
Minor Wreck Express saves you time and money.
Minor Wreck Express on Northwest Beaver Drive in Johnston.
Well, hi, I'm Rob Spearman. I'm a broker owner of RE/MAX Real Estate Concepts in Des Moines, Iowa. Give us a call if you're looking at buying or selling a home, or if you're having trouble on your mortgage payments or looking to purchase foreclosures. We have the agents to help you, experienced, outstanding agents. Our office number is 515-276-2872. Or if you'd like to look at homes, go to our website, homeconnectusa.com.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are. Let me ask you something. Is the fivefold ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you. What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see.
Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Lage. Well, on our break, I said, you know, the reason that you're saying this tonight is probably because somebody, and then God laid it on my heart that there is somebody out there that's been in your shoes that doesn't get it, and that they need to see this. Whether they see it tonight or they see it down the road, because they didn't understand what they were getting either, that it is from God, and God's trying to talk to them. And it's not just a normal dream. They're dreams that are directly from God. And that, you know, they need to get a hold of somebody, and they can call us. You know, they're on our website right now, or my cell phone's 515-229-0111. And they can call, and, you know, I can talk to them and let them know that this is real, that it is for today, and it's in the Bible, prophecy, but it's also for today, that people really do get words of knowledge, they do get visions, and they do get prophecy. So it's really cool, the gift that God's given you.
Thank you. It's actually in the Bible, in Joel 2:28-29, that God in the end times would pour out his prophecy on all flesh, and that people would prophesy, have visions and dreams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, we just have to say some of the things that have happened this last week, because, boy, God has really poured it out. He's really just been so amazing, and we've just had such a wonderful week. It's hard to even get it all in. Thursday night, we have a meeting at our home with the John G. Lake Ministry. Curry Blake has a live show every Thursday night. It's at 8 o'clock, and we have our meeting at 7, so we can talk about God things before it starts. But and then we pray for people after the video's over. And Curry's just always got so much amazing stuff to talk about. And we had a couple people that really had some chains broken off of them. Praise they were God. Really set free of things. And we had a lady there, Tiffany, who is a prophet, and she spoke over everybody there. God gave her words, and you know, Dave and I have a discerning spirit, and so we know when it's from God, and what she was saying over everybody was from God, and it's just truly amazing how that works out, and people are just uplifted and edified when you do that.
Well, one thing about it is she's one of the people that got hurt because the church didn't understand the gifts, the mainline right. stream church. And that happened to me. I don't know about your life, but when I was a little kid, I cried out to be like Samuel. I heard God's voice, and I started having visions, and nobody wanted to hear anything about, you know, the things that God was showing us. So it was a really cool thing because that she was so timid. She right. says, well, I said, you got something, don't you? A lot of times I'll get to see what they see, or at least part of it. That's why I know who to call on. And I said, this is free time. This is where you get to practice, where nobody's going to beat you up and throw you out the door. And it took a few times over. I said, you got something else, don't you? Well, yeah, but I didn't know if I told you before. This is, otherwise nobody gets to know how to use the gifts.
Right.
And then you're out in the war zone. And then you don't know what to do because you don't have any practice. So that's one of the things that we've been doing for almost 3 years now, is letting them, if it gets a little wild, we can fine-tune them there instead of when they're out trying to get somebody saved, healed, filled, delivered. And all of a sudden, she just got bold and she spoke over every person in the room.
It was cool. And she really enjoyed it, you know, because she hasn't been able to use it. You know, she just hasn't had a place where she could do it. She'd maybe get something little here or there, but God really used her in a mighty way Thursday night, and it was just so cool because she's like, I'm afraid, you know, I don't know, but it was a safe place, and you know, if somebody got out of hand, then we would rein him back in. But what she said was really all on track, and it was great. And she had a headache, and so did Amy, and they got prayed for, and both their headaches left. So and then John, a friend of ours, he had pain in his back and his side, and he actually, for the first time ever, saw a bunch of visions for other people and for himself. He saw like a door opening with light going through there. And I said, you're supposed to step. And I just motioned for him to come. And he stepped through into what God has for him. And it was really cool because then he got a lot more. And he's just such a changed man. You know, Thursday night, God did a mighty work on him. And then he continued on Saturday too. So it was really cool. And we had a meeting Friday night in Fort Dodge, a friend of ours, Sandy Mercer. She had a lot of family and friends that needed healing. And so we went up there, and it was so amazing. God just showed up in such a huge way. There was 10 kids, and I went outside, brought Oscar with us. He's been on our show before. And you know, when he prays for somebody and to ask Jesus into their heart, they just don't tell him no. So 10 kids got saved. And then God's given me the gift of praying for people to get filled with the Holy Spirit. So 6 of those 10 got filled with the Holy Spirit. Some of them left. And that's just so cool. They were like ages 13 to like 6 years old that all received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And it'll just help guide them throughout the rest of their life, you know? And there was some boys that were older that really had a call on their life that we prayed for, and that was just so neat. And there was two ladies that got filled with the Holy Spirit that I know of. Sometimes Dave's ministering in one place and I'm in another, and so I'm not sure, there could have been more. But it was really neat. Do you want to tell some of the things that happened?
Well, this young lady comes up and I really don't want to know too much about your problems if you come and ask us to pray. Just tell me where it hurts. And the reason being is, and the answer B here is, she had pain in her ankle. So we prayed, like Curry says, first. And she says, well, I still have, but you grab the hands and you hit all of it. And then you get it fine-tuned as you need to. So she says, well, I have pain in my ankle. And this is where the story comes in, is I prayed for her ankle and she said, the pain left. I said, do something you couldn't do. So she's up walking and jumping on it, and she's just totally just amazed. And then we find out that there was all kinds of metal plates, screws put in there, and the doctors said it could never do that.
She'd never be able to walk.
I didn't know that until after the fact.
Yeah, it makes it easier sometimes.
And then she gave her heart to Jesus.
Yeah.
She was struggling with some things that she couldn't get over, and she was set free of that. She started speaking in a heavenly language, got baptized, and then she prayed for the next lady, and she fell out under the power of God.
And there was at least three people that she prayed for that got healed after that. I didn't see it, but Tony was with us, and he sent me an email, helped me with some of the details, because if I'm in the other room, it's just hard to get it all. So he said she prayed for three other people that got healed after that. And she had pain in her hips. I can't remember now if she had hip surgery or what it was, but she had pain in her hips. And before the night was over, she was doing like a hula hoop, like you have one of those things around you, and twisting her hips around. She's like, I haven't done that for a long time. And then she could only bend over like to touch her knees. And she bent over and touched the floor before the end of the night was over. And she said, I'm even standing up taller. I'm standing up straighter. Like she'd gotten her confidence back.
Yes, and wonderful.
She was just grinning ear to ear. And she just couldn't stop smiling. And it's just so neat when you see somebody come in and you see how they're quiet and reserved. And just like, you know, that they have hurts and pains in their heart, you know. And before the end of the night, she was wound for sound, just on fire for the Lord. And I just know God is going to use her in a mighty way. Amanda, before we even got started,
a lady came in and I said, you got pain, don't you? Well, yeah. I said, well, no sense you sitting here for the whole thing. So I had her hand her hands out like Curry teaches. It doesn't have to be as specific as a lot of us used to think. I just grabbed her hands and said, go. She shook. Is she getting pain? Nope. Okay, so when everybody got in, I asked her again, and some of the pain come back, so we did it again. And I've known this lady off and on for years, and she sat there smiling for the first time ever that I've ever seen her. And she got ministered to by different people through the night, but she was sitting there smiling. So a lot of things got broke off that we don't know about.
Right, yeah. And there was another lady that she was so shy, she didn't want even to be prayed for in front of the other people, so I took her in another room and prayed for her, and she had fibromyalgia, and all the pain left her body, and then she got filled with the Holy Spirit. So it's just amazing what God can do, you know, and so quickly. You know, it doesn't take some hour prayer, you know.
Absolutely.
Or another book or another teaching or anything.
Yeah.
God wrote the perfect book, and so many times people want to add to it. Well, it's like a recipe. When you put too many extra ingredients in, pretty soon nobody even wants it. And the purer you keep, and we make a lot of mistakes, I'm not saying that, but anytime we can fine-tune ourselves and find a better, quicker, easier way of doing something, and we've been through a lot of different teachings on divine healing, like the happy hunters, they just had fun. And hundreds of people got healed at every one of their meetings.
There was another lady that I guess she had pain in her back in three different places, and you guys prayed for her. I was in the other room, and some of it was in her lower back, And before the end of the night, she was healed from everything, from her head to her toes. And she was soaking in the presence of God for a while. God was doing some stuff with her. You know, sometimes he just needs us to be quiet and soak, and he's got things to work on it. So she really got changed that night. And I guess there was a couple people that their legs grew out, two of them.
At least.
Did you pray over them? Okay.
At least.
Yeah. And so that's always neat because, you know, if your one leg's longer than the other, it's kind of makes it hard on your back, hard to sleep, hard to walk. So, and the people were watching, and so it grew out before their eyes. And so these people that had never seen this kind of stuff before, it's cool because they really get to see it and witness something actually happening. Because if, you know, you say, my back doesn't hurt anymore, well, they can't see that. They don't really know before their very eyes. Because some people don't like, they don't believe until they see it.
But
so
when it's their foot or their best friend's foot, and they're both skeptics, that, you know, they know their friend wouldn't do anything like that, and all of a sudden it just, sometimes it's 2 inches. Just, are you doing that? No, and I've never felt anything like this. Well, I'm not pulling on your leg. I know you're not, but I'm not doing it either. And I love ministering to them type of people, the skeptics. And I'm kind of a warrior anyway. The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and our friend Tony that's helping with our marketing ideas and some administrative stuff, he came down from Minnesota this last weekend, and he had a ball. He was very helpful, and God was using him in a mighty way, too. He was praying for people, and they were getting healed and set free.
He went to a new level.
Yeah, God really, really changed him and used him. And he has he's a psalmist, and he has a voice that... he's made records, and God's going to use that too. We know that, but we were really proud of him, and thank you, Tony, very much for all you did this weekend. And he's really helping with editing our stuff. And sometimes it just takes a long time. I don't have time to do everything, so it's very, very helpful. And so he was helped us Friday night, and then also Saturday night. We have a meeting in our home every Saturday night at 7:30. And there was a lady, she had a curved spine, and her left shoulder was at least 2 inches lower than her right shoulder. And she had a lump on her back shoulder blade, and she just had all kinds of chronic fear, worry, anxiety, nightmares, you name it. She just had all kinds of stuff. And different people prayed over her. And I know Oscar, our adopted dad, he gave her a Jesus hug. And when he does that, it's so cool. After he did that prayer, then her shoulders were level. And it was really neat because it's like, how
can the lump left?
Yeah. It's like, how can a hug, well, when God's
behind it.
He hugged
with the authority of Jesus.
Yeah, he did. And it's so neat. God's let me be able to do that to people sometimes. And, one of our friends, he wasn't quite receiving. And then Virginia was there, and she got to give him a Jesus hug. And so I know that he really received that. So that was really cool. So what, you have a whirlwind story or a vision?
No, there was one time that there was a spirit had come against our church, and we were struggling with it, and we decided to take it on and get rid of it out of the church.
Right.
And when that happened, all kinds of manners of things, spiritual warfare actually came down on our church.
Uh-huh.
And I literally opened my door the morning that after we started taking this on.
Uh-huh.
And a wind from the east, which isn't normal, came in so hard the dog came back and hit me.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. And but that later that day we were out on the road in the field working at what we do, our regular jobs, and my co-pastor was down the driveway, and a wind came up, and I actually got picked up in the air along with the gravity wagon. So this was a major win.
Wow.
But I hollered out to Gary, and the wind, he had a hat on. It wasn't blowing over there, just a few feet away at all. It was quite an experience, the spiritual warfare, but it did break. There was quite a lot of, we gave quite a lot of resistance in. God's always going to be the victor.
Right. Amen.
God's always going to be the victor.
Well, yeah. I just seen something when you said that. You guys usually go out and minister in pairs.
Yes.
And there's something about that, because Jesus, when he walked the earth, he always sent them out in pairs.
Mm-hmm.
So if the enemy attacks one of you, you always got one on solid ground. If one falls, the other one's supposed to lift him up.
Right.
I know. I when I went up in the air, I went up maybe 10, 12 feet, but,
oh, wow.
But I got gently brought back down. But
that had to be, quite the experience.
That was a pretty intense 3 or 4 days there. I've never had spiritual warfare come at me.
Yeah.
Me personally.
Yeah.
And it was strong. It was, I don't want to sound like a crazy, but it was real. I wouldn't have believed yet quite on the level that,
right.
That I sure do now.
We understand that. We've had some, maybe not quite the same way, but different things. So we totally understand that. So we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. Thank you.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
No matter how well you drive, stuff happens.
Angry? Who's angry?
And with so many ways to damage your car, there's one right way to fix it.
Minor Wreck Express saves you time and money.
Minor Wreck Express on Northwest Beaver Drive in Johnston.